Hey guys, so we've been cleared to play with horses as long as the horses stay in their pens and we disinfect all equipment before and after. So pretty excited about that. I've been working a lot on positive reinforcement target training with Hickory. I have no clue what I'm doing, but I am trying my best. And so far it's been working pretty good with him. If you're familiar with Hickory, he is pretty skittish. He's not really trusting of people. He loves objects. Like, he will go play with a tarp, play with like jolly balls, everything that he can get his mouth on, he goes and plays with it. But he does not trust people. And so we've had a long road to getting him to trust people at all. And he's come a long ways. And then with this target training, he's come a lot more. So pretty excited about that. I'm still going to be out of the 100 day bracket with the horsemanship challenge because I didn't play with the horses for 20 days and we only had a 20 day allowance for off days with the challenge, but I'm still going to easily make the 60 day. So pretty excited about that. But this has been working really good with him because he can leave me whenever he wants to. This is 100% choice. There is really no like negative reinforcement, which is like taking away pressure. There's really none of that. The difference between positive reinforcement and negative reinforcement: positive reinforcement, you are introducing a primary reinforcer such as food. Food is something that they need to survive, so innately they're going to want food. This all works with humans, especially kids, so similar like psychology behind it. Negative reinforcement is where you take something away. So your cue is pressure, and when they do what you want, you take the pressure away. So you make the right thing easy and the wrong thing hard. But with positive reinforcement, you just make the right thing fun and the wrong thing just happens. So some horses I think truly do great on positive reinforcement. I also think some horses do great on the negative reinforcement, but I'm very new to this, so I'm probably making a lot of mistakes, but I feel like we're doing pretty okay so far. Basically, after, like, every time I touch him or ask him to touch the stick, my little makeshift stick, I click when he does the right thing. So I click my mouth, and that tells him that it's the right thing. And it's a different click than, like, smooching at him or, you know, the clicking to get him to go. It's more of like a, instead of a, or, you know, if you're familiar with horse people, we'd say weird stuff, make weird noises. So I make sure to make it different and like different frequency, you know, so he's hearing, oh, I did good, I'm gonna get food now, rather than like pressure. So basically how I started was I would do my little positive click and then I would give him food back and forth. I didn't film that part of it, unfortunately, but I did a lot of that to where when I clicked, he looked at me and was like, where's my food, where's my food? So then I paired that with the little water bottle stick, and so every time like I brought the stick close to him, I would click and give him food. And he got to where, oh, I really want to follow that stick. And I got him where he was touching the stick and then touching it different ways. So like having it above his head, like right here, and reaching up and like touching it, but and then having it low, like between his legs, and him reaching down and touching it side to side, forwards, backwards, all of that. So, and he's at about 3.5 feet, maybe 4 feet away from me. So he has plenty of distance for his own sake, but we're close enough that he's coming near me and really understanding that, like, I'm there and I'm trustworthy. So he's been having a lot of fun with this. He's super food motivated, which helps a lot, and he loves objects, so he'll play with stuff all the time. So him getting to play with a water bottle stick is like the greatest thing for him, because that crinkly noise, I don't know why, but that's one of his favorite things, is that little crinkly noise. So this is kind of what I'm doing. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully this all makes sense. And yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.